activation energy is the energy required to remove an electron from the ground state of a gas atom or ion. All right?
All right.
So here we go. The first ionization energy is the energy required to remove the first electron. Then you have the second ionization energy. That is the energy it takes to remove the second electron. Like, let's say if you have sodium, which one do you think is going to be higher? The first ionization energy or the second ionization?
Second.
Why?
Because the second one is already full. The two is...
Remember, don't use the terms that we've learned today.
I don't understand that.
Infected nuclear charge,
oh,
and
so
forth.
Would it be a bigger size?
No size.
Oh, it's on the top.
At what point? The effective nuclear charge, at what point would it be higher?
The second one?
After you removed your first
electron. It's going to take more because you said once you lose it, they get.
There you go.
They get bigger, so you have to reach.
No,
they
get
tighter.
Like when you lose your 17-year-old, right? That's
yes.
What you were saying? Okay.
So when you lose your first electron, your sodium becomes like what? When you lose your first electron, your sodium becomes like what? It becomes like neon. So it is stable, it is happy. You've lost the electron, the effective nuclear charge has increased. You're stable because now you have the electronic configuration of a noble gas.
Mm-hmm.
Now you're trying to disrupt that by taking another electron. So the amount of energy that you have to use to get rid of the second electron is going to be much greater. Do we get that? Okay. Here's an example of what we're talking about. The first ionization energy for sodium is 496 kilojoules per mole. The ionization energy of the second electron is 4,562 kilojoules per mole.
Do you remember that?
No, you don't remember these things. You're just looking at the trend. Okay? So now, if you look at magnesium, the first ionization energy, it's 738 kJs per mole. Second ionization energy, 1451 kJs per mole. How much electrons does magnesium want to lose and be happy with it?
Two.
Two. The third ionization energy is 7,733 kilojoules per mole.
Yeah.
Okay? So if you see the trend, the higher your ionization, the order of your ionization, the more energy it will take. Once you get to your stable electronic configuration for whatever your metal is, you will need a significantly more amount of energy to remove this electron.
Argon also lose the electron.
It can, but look how much energy it takes just to lose one. Okay? So now, here's a think like Nika question. Okay? When you're looking at these numbers, what can you tell me about these numbers?
They big.
There's a trend.
Yeah, they are big. But aside from magnitude, there's something else that is extremely important about these numbers as a whole. Not looking at their trend, but these numbers as a whole.
It's four times.
No. Looking at these numbers as a whole, what can you tell me about them that is similar, that not similar, but that is the same, exactly the same for all of them?
Is the ratio of increasing number?
Nope. It's not a trend. It's not a trend. Everything is the same.
Can you stop that? That's just distracting me. That's distracting me. I don't know.
Think about it.
I'm really in the same group.
Mm-hmm. I think that was the
trend. Like, Finn, no. That's what I'm saying.
It's not because
you. Think like Mika. Think outside of the box. What do you see? It's so there that you're skipping it over.
Me.
But I don't want you to skip it over. What do you think?
I think it's because each time you we move like.
No.
It's getting from bigger and smaller.
No.
Smaller to bigger.
No.
The Eimer shells.
No.
I don't know.
Every second one has an even number.
No.
So like
I don't think like that now.
The bigger the number,
nope.
The more
adventure. What's the question again?
What is the same for all of these numbers? It has to do with the process. What is this process called? This process right here. What you doing right here?
And you added energy,
no, sign. Ooh, you hitting on it. You hitting on it. You hitting on it. What is it?
Oh, no.
Yeah, promise to review and this one.
The ionization energy. What do you do when you ionize?
Can we get a cat?
Release energy.
Lose an electron.
So you're making it more of a cation.
You're making it into a cation. So now, think about that. Put that together.
It takes a lot of energy to make a cation, I guess.
Link it together.
I don't know.
Yes, you do.
I don't know.
You're beating around the bush. I want you to smash it.
Yes,
think of put all these things together. These are ionization energy. What do you need to do to ionize something?
You need to lose a lot of energy. You need more energy. Less to make it more.
All right, Ben, we learned it. We learned this in chapter 5.
What? Entropy!
Entropy!
No way.
These are kilojoules per mole. What about them? What is exactly the same for all of them?
It's increasing.
No!
The amount of kilojoules it takes for each one.
Say it again?
The amount of kilojoules it takes for each one? I don't know.
Yes, you do know. Stop telling me you don't know.
I don't. I did. I will be telling you.
Huh? No. What about the heat?
The more the heat increases, the
just
more...
No!
The heat, no, not
no.
The specific heat.
No!
Entropy of formation.
Just tell
no.
You.
No!
Stressing me out.
Oh,
boy. But it's multiplication.
No multiplication. What do you mean with the heat that you just learned that like 2 days ago?
Now
I'm going to the lambda.
What? Y'all give up?
Yeah, what?
Really?
No. Batman,
no
quitting up.
Yeah, exactly. So, Batman, what's my answer?
Heat.
What about the heat?
You said they're all in kilojoules.
They're all in kilojoules per mole. What is so?
It's feeling
they're
heat.
All in thousands.
No!
No?
Who said it? Who said it?
My son.
Yes.
What about?
Oh my God! What about again?
What about that beautiful word?
Because it's positive. It's
Absorbing.
It's absorbing.
It's absorbing. What do you have to do in order to get an electron to leave?
Hot it up.
You need to hot it up. You need to put energy
on
in it.
Turn off ESC on it. Yes.
You need.
No, because I have a question.
Hell
right,
no.
So I had a bottle the other day and it wouldn't open. So then, like, I put it under hot water and then I got it open.
No, that's something different.
Okay.
So in that case, all you're doing is expanding the plastic.
And
it wasn't plastic.
Energy.
Same difference. You're expanding it so that allows it to release from the cap. So even though you may not realize it, but glass can expand and contract. Okay? All right. So all of these numbers, all of these values are positive. They're all positive because these are endothermic processes, because you need to add energy to your atom in order to remove an electron.
So when you say adding energy, the system is absorbing heat.
The system is absorbing this energy to get rid of
you. Energy, not in the form of heat. It can be any.
It can be heat, it can be light.
So, what is an example?
Let's bring it home, okay? Let's say you just want to break a pencil.
Okay.
What do you need to do? Are you just going to leave the pencil right there?
No.
Break.
Apply some force.
You're going to have to add force to it in order to break it.
So add
this
energy
is exactly, huh?
So we're adding energy here to...
You're adding energy in order to remove it. This is the thing, like, Nick, you gotta think about, but you gotta link things together.
So when we're gonna add the energy, it's gonna be, we're gonna jump it up.
We'll jump it up.
The electron, because it's adding the energy.
But
there's
a difference between adding enough energy to excite an electron versus adding enough energy to remove an electron.
You need more energy.
You need more energy to remove it.
So that means when you add energy, it started exited the electron. When you add more, enough to make it jump it up,
mm-hmm.
When you add more, that's just going forward.
Yes. Yes.
That means, like, as your example, when you have 3 months, you have 7 minutes go fast. When you add more energy, like if you add more another tool, it's going to more fast, but one time it's gone. You can't.
Yes. So it's like I have a 17-year-old. A 10-year-old, a 1-year-old, a 3-month-old.
And more and more.
Now, I got a 2-month-old right here.
And the 7-year-old right.
So now, the 17-year-old is about, she done leave. Now my 10-year-old's trying to act funny like, yeah, mommy, you can't tell me nothing. You hurt me. You can't move too fast. So now, I got too much hold on the 10-year-old because he acting all smart. Okay? So... Same concept. Okay?
What is that?
Endothermic?
This one, like the symbol. Proportional?
You mean infinity sign?
No, it's proportional. Something like what?
Oh, he's saying proportional?
So if you add the energy, it depends on the electron jumping. Electrons jump
anymore?
Oh. Yeah. More you add the energy, more electron release.
So
yes.
Proportional to
electron
release. The orbital.
Like electron or remove is proportional to the energy.
What?
Like if you give the more energy, more electron will be released.
Yes.
It's proportional to, right?
Yes. So the more energy you add to your system, the more electron, well, it depends on if it hits the threshold. If it hits the threshold, then it will be released. If not, then you'll just have your electrons being excited.
We don't have one similar. You see that sodium, the second one is 4, 5, 6. That goes third one, when magnesium is second one, is like times double. It's 4 times.
No, don't think about doubles and triples and stuff like that. Don't think about that.
Don't think about
that.
Part
of
the
there in Formula 2?
Is there a way you can just write them out because I don't see them together? So
don't see what together?
I was about to explain. So when you have like ionization, what happens when you release, you're getting rid of an electron?
This is it?
Right. So but before that, it's like something we did in chapter 5 where you add it in, you have Na plus.
This is all called
ionization energy.
No, there's no formula. So you're just saying anytime I'm getting rid of an electron, it is an endothermic process.
Damn. Like, when we like, do that,
is there an increase in energy when it does the second ionization?
And you lose 2.
That's in chapter 8, but these are chapter 8.
We're going full class today. No,
We're gonna take out of the lab because the lab we don't have much to do in lab, but so we'll take 30 minutes.
Yeah, nothing to do.
Till 1:15 for the lab. We'll start at 1:15.
For 5 minutes.
No, five minutes. We got that. Y'all taking up my extra time.
I didn't do nothing.
When?
Well, let me finish this. So trends of the ionization energy going from left to right.
Okay.
Ionization energy is going to increase. Can we link that?
No.
Can we link that to effective nuclear charge?
Left to right is this bigger to smaller.
Yes. So as your effective nuclear charge increases, your ionization energy also increases.
Yeah.
Get that?
Because it grows tighter in there.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So the tighter you hold, the more energy it needs to take it away. So going from bottom to top, ionization energy increases. Mm-hmm. Okay, so there's some anomalies, right?
Okay.
So if you look here, remember that the trend is going from left to right, the ionization energy is going to increase.
Mm-hmm.
You see that there's a dip at 3A, and then you increase again. Then there's another dip at 6A. And then it increases again. There's a reason for this. If we look at the atomic orbital diagram, we can explain this. Your electron in group 3A is removed from your p orbital. So if we look at boron, this is the electronic, atomic orbital diagram for boron. Your electron is removed from your p orbital. So it's further away from your nucleus. So you don't have that much pull on it. Plus, your 2s is saying, you are blocking my view. We don't really want you here. Right? So it now is also adding repulsion to your 2p electron, making it easier for it to be removed. Do we get that?
Okay.
Okay. Now, in 6A, you have the electron is being removed from a doubly occupied orbital. So in terms of oxygen, here you have your atomic orbital diagram. The electron that's being removed is the one that's in the doubly occupied orbital. So you have now repulsion from this other electron, making it easier for it to leave. So let's bring it home. If you and your little brother, y'all sharing the bed,
mm-hmm.
okay? Brother's a bad sleeper. Mama comes into the room and says, all right, you know, I feel bad for you. I'm gonna take your little brother and he can come sleep with me. What are you gonna do?
Mommy, no. Like, you can stay. Let him stay, it's okay.
Go. Or are you gonna go, leave him, take him, just go. Okay? You're gonna say take him. So So now you are adding repulsion to that to make it easier for this electron to go. Do we get that?
Mm-hmm.
And that's only for group 16?
Yeah. That's group 16.
No.
So you're saying that it's going to remove from where it's double occupied, so that it just would have a single energy.
Yes.
So we have to know this thing?
Yes. If it wasn't here, why is it here if you didn't know it?
Hold up.
We have to just not going to give us the number.
Okay,
let me finish quick. We're going to take a question, okay? Of these three elements, this what you have here is the first ionization energy. My question is, which one of these three will have the highest second ionization energy? Calcium?
I'm not sure.
And H.
Sodium.
Why is it sodium?
Sodium because it's increasing it's on the left side, and compared between sodium and calcium, it's down to up, it's increasing.
What?
Sulfur.
No,
remember, that's first ionization energy.
Oh,
that's a trend for the first ionization energy. I'm asking you about the second ionization energy.
Did you say
NaL
just
one
now valence?
Which one?
Sodium is over in the left.
Second ionization energy. This is the first ionization energy. I want the second.
So what you were just saying only applies.
That is your first ionization energy.
Sodium.
Your first ionization energy, you'll see a dip.
Oh.
Right? But I'm asking about your second ionization energy. Which one of these will have the highest second ionization energy?
Sodium.
Why do you say sodium?
First ionization energy is related to a noble gas. From noble gas to actual.
Very good. Right? So with sodium, once you remove your first electron, that leads you to neon. You are happy. You have reached the pinnacle of elements and ions. Okay? You don't want to go any further. If you now try to remove another one, you're taking away my stability. You're about to mess with my head right now. Like you're messing with my self-worth. So you're going to need a lot more energy in order to remove an electron from that stable noble gas configuration.
Okay, now I'm interested.
With calcium, you need two.
Yeah.
You need to remove two.
Be as hard.
So it won't be that bad because you want to get to that noble gas and you need two steps to do it.
Okay.
With sulfur, you're going backwards.
A lot.
You're going backwards to silicon. So that, you're okay with that because you're not getting towards where your noble gas structure is, okay? So here is our second ionization energy, calcium, 1145, sulfur, 2252.
Sodium,
4562. I'm sorry, I'm not understanding. What part of
what you understand? You said it's the second, so for the first ionization, is sodium not at neon?
No. Well, it is. But the second ionization, I'm telling you, I want the second ionization energy.
So then it's removing two electrons?
It's moving two electrons. It doesn't want to do that. Because after the first one, it's perfectly fine.
Because everybody wants to be in the
why
shit. So why would it not be something like calcium?
What do you mean, why would it not be something like calcium?
So you're moving two electrons. If it's for sodium and you already reached neon, if calcium is going to just move to it, get to argon, it'll get Y.
I'm telling you, you're moving to. That's why.
No, I understand that. I'm saying I don't understand why it's not higher.
Why calcium is not higher?
Yes.
Because calcium wants to get to
argon.
Thank you.
So does neon. I mean, so does sodium.
Yeah,
no,
but
but
one.
It only needs one
right,
to
so
get.
I would have a higher one for the second one.
Because what happens when you remove? How am I going to behave with my 10-year-old? I'm going to be more strict. I'm going to pull him in. So if I'm pulling it in, and now you're saying, okay, we're going to have to take your 10-year-old. I wish you would. I want to see you try. How much energy do you think it's going to take in order to remove my 10-year-old from my side?
So you're saying if it's easier in the first ionization level to...
Give me 1 second. Cut it out. Don't make me get on you right now. Cut it out. Go ahead.
If it's easier to get to the a noble gas in the first ionization level,
mm-hmm.
Then it's going to be more difficult to remove it
from that configuration.
For a second ionization
yes.
level. So that's why it's more...
It takes more energy, yes.
Okay.
So, since you lost one with sodium,
mm-hmm.
and now you're losing another one,
mm-hmm.
so you're sick. Now, in calcium, you just losing two for the first time? So you're like...
Yeah, so...
But sulfur, the reason why sulfur is not even in the question is because you're gaining two. So
you're not gaining two, you're still losing two.
With sulfur?
Yes.
But it's nowhere near the noble
but
gas.
But it's not nowhere near where your noble gas is. So
oh,
again, it does take more. It does take a lot more energy to remove that second electron. But it's not going to be... Sulfur is not in its... stable electronic configuration. Tell me. All right. Electron affinity is the amount of energy associated with the gain of electrons. Looking at this before we go into the trend, what exactly can you tell me about electron affinity? Very good. It is an exothermic process. So once you gain energy, you are going to lose or give up your energy. Right? So now, going from left to right, you become more exothermic. However, you now see that you have a dip. You have a dip at 2A, and you have a dip at 5A, right? So now, if these are greater than zero, what exactly does that mean? It is positive. It is positive. It is what?
Endothermic.
So that means you need for these rows, these columns, sorry, you must add energy in order to get an electron in there. Why is that? We shall see. When you are in groups 1A and 2A, you are adding electrons to a P orbital, not the S orbital. So here for beryllium, you're adding an electron here. So but this electron sees your 2S electron. So it's saying, you are blocking my view. I don't really want you here. So now we're going to feel repulsion. All right? In groups 4A and 5A, you have no empty orbitals. They're all occupied. So now, in order to add an electron in there, you must add it to a already occupied orbital. So therefore, you must add energy to force another electron in there. Do we get that? Yes, no, maybe, however. And I believe that's it.